I'm here at Prismic, and I'm glad to be here with Wes Bos. Wes, can you introduce a little bit yourself?
Sure. My name is Wes Bos. I'm a full-stack JavaScript developer all the way from Canada, and I make JavaScript courses and web development and have a podcast called Syntax.
And we're talking about there are two new things in React, Hooks and Suspense, that have been released, right?
So Hooks is, at the time recording, Hooks just got in last week. Suspense is still being worked, so some of this might change, but it should probably come out in maybe 6 months or so from time of recording.
Cool. And let's start with Hooks then.
Yeah.
Right? Can you explain what Hooks are and why are they interesting?
Hooks solve the problem of being able to inject stateful logic and side effects into your component. So the way that we currently do it is you have a class that extends the React.component. Inside of that class, you generally have a render, which outputs your HTML. And then if you want data inside of that, you'll have state. And then if you want to like do things at different times of the life cycle of that, you've got component will mount, component did update, and component will unmount. And in those three things, you generally inject logic as to things that need to happen at those lifecycle methods, right?
And the problem with that, as you told me before, that it's everyone handles their own way, right? There's no one way of doing that.
Yeah, the way that we solve that now is if you don't want to attach what it does with what it looks like, which is your render and your functionality, what we do now is we used to have mix-ins, those are gone in React, and then we have high order components, and then that sort of fell out of love in order of render props, and that worked well, but it's this like ugly arrow syntax where if you have four or five things you need inside of it, it's nested really deeply. So what Hooks aim to do is to take all that state and logic and everything and move that into a separate function that you can easily use to inject data and functionality into your regular components. So we're going to just have your components now are just going to be functions. Classes aren't going anywhere, but you can just have a regular function that returns some JSX.
Simple.
And if you want to inject data or functionality or subscribe to a database or anything else that's sort of like that, you create what's called a hook. And then inside of the hook is where you sort of tuck all of the logic and stuff into it. And then inside of your render function of your original component, you can access the data and the functionality through
and interact with it.
And interact with it. Yeah. Right.
So more concretely, it's like how would the syntax look like?
So the way that it works is you imagine you have a function that returns some JSX. Before you do that return, you would say like const, and let's use state for an example. If you want to have age, you use an array. And the first thing in the array is going to be your piece of state, your variable that's updated.
And the second, that you can use it for the render.
Exactly. Right? So you're like const square bracket age, comma, update age. The second thing is an updater function. And then that is returned from a use state hook. So you run use state, you pass it your initial value. Under the hood, that's all memoized, meaning that if the component were to be re-rendered, it doesn't start from scratch again. It knows internally that thing's been run already. And that's cool because then just below that in your render, you then have access to this live variable called age, and you then have access to this updater function, which you then can call anytime you want to update that value.
Right. Seems much simpler. But then can you give us a concrete example of a, like maybe shopping cart component?
Yeah. So let's
say, what are the things that you would use hooks for in a shopping cart?
You've got a shopping cart component. And inside of that, you might have some state, which is the things that are in your shopping cart. You might have some functions to remove items from your shopping cart, update the number of items in your shopping cart. And then you might have some other like side effects where maybe you're syncing that to the database. Maybe you've got some other functions that would like sync it to some like event reporting. Maybe like this user added it to the cart.
Marketing.
Yeah, marketing, things that everybody needs to hook into that. So there you go. It's called a hook. there's a lot going on there. And previously what you do is you stuff all those things in all of your lifecycle methods, even though they're not totally related, right? So what we can do now is you could use a hook for your state, which is your items in your cart. You could use another hook for all the functions and updating that, or you can create your own hooks, which internally can have state and updater functions and all of your own custom logic, which is cool. And then you can make like just a separate hook that's for marketing called like use marketing hooks or something like that. And all that will do is just you can just run those functions nice and tidily. And I really like that because you can just like tuck all the messiness of that functionality into its own hook and then just expose it via the use hook API inside of your render.
Especially you can make, as you said, different hooks, right? So you don't have to mix some marketing code, you know, the things that are, you know, triggering something in marketing to mix it up with the functionality actually of synchronizing with the database.
Exactly.
You can make different hooks for that.
Yeah, exactly.
Right. So it seems like maybe React is finally being opinionated on something. Right? It's like they're having an opinion and they're suggesting a way to fix this.
Yeah,
kind of thing.
That's the thing about React is they've been very unopinionated about how to handle these things, and high order components and render props have come out of just like us figuring out like hacks we can do with functions and whatnot. And it's really cool that they have now come out with a first class API for doing this type of thing. And we can talk about that with Suspense as well.
Yeah.
Suspense is a new API that's coming to React. This might change, but previously dealing with data and like asynchronous fetching, we say data, but it could be for fetching any sort of stuff behind any sort of asynchronous calls behind the scenes. The way that it's going to work and the problem that Suspense will solve is that where you fetch your data and where you want to maybe show like a loading indicator is not necessarily always in the same place. So we've all been to websites where you load it and you see 6 or 7 different loaders really quickly because
That's really ugly. I mean, when you start, and it's very hard to solve. I mean, when you see it on the website, you say, like, why did they do it that way? But it's extremely tricky to solve.
Well, we just got done talking about componentizing and keeping the query with the component in this nice, tidy little package. And that sort of falls apart when you need to like talk to the higher component and tell them like, hey, I'm loading something, right? So the solution is just show a loading indicator where you're fetching the data. So what Suspense will do is it will allow us to take our asynchronous calls. So whether that's fetching a bundle of code, whether that's fetching some data from an API, or whether that's loading an image, and we can turn those calls into what are called resources. And then when just kind of like how we like hooks work, before your render, you can read a resource, and it looks like a synchronous function where before the render happens, this read function from your resource will return the data to you. And the kind of cool little thing about that is you can also use a cache, meaning that you can preload them, or if you want to render something twice, it's not going to fetch the data twice. So it'll take care of the caching for you as well.
So it's pretty much about wrapping that call with another function.
Yep.
And then use that function instead, and then that's it. React is it knows about that that's happening, and then you can use it at a higher level, you know, component that will be able to know about, okay, the fetching is done, then I can stop the loading.
Yeah, so you forget about loading in your component altogether because you just read this resource and then it will render when the resource is read. And then at a higher level, you can wrap it in a Suspense component. In that Suspense component, you can dictate what will show when it's loading. So if you've got like a user component that's fetching and maybe a list of their GitHub projects, that's 2 requests. And you could wrap both of those in a Suspense component that will maybe just show like a dummy component or show a loading indicator entirely. So you don't have to show the entire loading component, or sorry, you don't need to show the entire user component at that time.
Right.
Another cool thing it does is that you can specify the delay. So if you've been to a website and you have a fast connection, you might see 6 or 7 loaders for 200 milliseconds, just really quick. And you can say like, all right, for the first 500 milliseconds, don't show anything. And if the resource is taking longer than that, then show a loader.
But that, it will do it for all the components at a global level.
Yes, yeah.
Yeah, that's a cool thing about it. You don't have to handle it at all at the level of the component, but then at the global level, the loader will be able to wait enough and then start showing the loading indicator because you need more time, right?
Yeah, you don't need to like dispatch all these loading events and catch them at a higher level and then figure out 6 of the 7 are finished loading or whatever. You can just wrap a couple of resources in a suspense tag and figure out what UI to show at that point.
Way simpler.
Yes. Yeah. Absolutely. I'm looking forward to it.
Cool. Thank you very much for explaining this.
Absolutely. Thanks for having me.
Cool.